हेलो क्लास 7, लेट्स कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर 6, एनर्जी एंड पावर रिसोर्सेस। वी स्टडीड रिन्यूएबल एंड नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस, विच आर कॉल्ड रिन्यूएबल एज नॉन कन्वेंशनल एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस एंड नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस एज कन्वेंशनल एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस। कन्वेंशनल रिसोर्सेस, एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस, दोज विल बी फिनिश्ड सून, वन डे दे विल बी फिनिश्ड, लाइक पेट्रोलियम, कोल, ओके। एंड नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज और कन्वेंशनल एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज आर दोज विच विल नेवर फिनिश। दे कैन बी दे विल बी रिन्यूड, लाइक सोलर एनर्जी एंड विंड एनर्जी, टाइडल एनर्जी, जियोथर्मल एनर्जी, ओके। सो टूडे we will be studying about petroleum or mineral oil. Mineral oil, petroleum, they are also non-renewable energy resources or conventional energy resources. Okay, petroleum, petra, this petroleum word has taken from a Latin word which means oil और रॉक ऑयल, ओके। रॉक ऑयल लाइक पेट्रा, पेट्रा मीन्स रॉक एंड ओलियम मीन्स ऑयल, रॉक ऑयल। दस पेट्रोलियम इज ऑयल ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम रॉक्स, पर्टिकुलरली सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स ऑफ द अर्थ। वी गेट पेट्रोलियम वेयर द सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स आर प्रेजेंट, देयर ओनली पेट्रोलियम आर प्रेजेंट, ओके। नाउ पेट्रोलियम, पेट्रोलियम और मिनरल ऑयल, पेट्रोलियम इज एन इनफ्लेमेबल लिक्विड दैट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन्स। इनफ्लेमेबल, द मीनिंग ऑफ इनफ्लेमेबल इज ऑल्सो फ्लेमेबल, ओके। इनफ्लेमेबल लिक्विड दैट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन्स। Significance of petroleum. It is used as a fuel and has revolutionized transportation on land, in air and on water. India is not a major producer of mineral oil. The oil reserves of India are estimated to be about 4,000 million tons. India produces about 33 million tons of crude petroleum. About 63 of it produced from Mumbai High, 18% from Gujarat and 16% from Assam. All three states produces what? Produces mineral oil in India. They are the major producing mineral oil states. Okay. Now, uses of petroleum. Uses of petroleum. It is the major source of power for vehicles. It provides the most important lubricating agents and is used as important raw material for various petrochemical products like synthetic rubber and plastics, synthetic fibers, dyestuffs, insecticides, drugs and pharmaceuticals, okay. So for these industries petroleum provides raw material also. Now, need for conservation of energy resources. Why should we conserve energy resources? Most of the energy resources are limited. Non-renewable energy resources, they are limited. It takes millions of years to form. It takes millions years to form important energy resources like coal or petroleum. Overuse of these energy resources also leads to pollution. These energy resources also cause pollution. Coal, if we burn coal, it pollutes the atmosphere. And also, if we use petroleum, that time also it pollutes our atmosphere. Now, fourth one, energy is basic requirement for economic development. Every sector of economy needs energy for its development. Due to industrialization, modernization, and urbanization, the consumption of energy in all forms has been steadily rising all over the world because of industrialization. Because of industrialization, modernization, energy resources are required. They are necessary for the development in the field of industrialization, modernization, and urbanization. That's why the consumption of energy in all forms has been steadily rising all over the world. How can we save or how can we conserve energy resources? There is need to develop a sustainable path of energy development, a sustainable path, that is energy development, but not at the cost of environment or needs of future generation. We should save energy resources for future generation, for coming generation. Also, we should conserve energy resources. Judicious use of limited energy resources. Judicious means sensible or wise use of limited energy resources. We should use energy resources wisely, or wherever it is needed, there only we should use. We should not waste. Wastage of minerals should be minimized. That's all for the day. You have to do all these exercises in book. All these exercises in book. And send your assignments regularly and on time. I want you all to send assignments on time. Okay, that's all for the day. Thank you, and we will start new chapter, weathering and soil formation, in next video. Thank you.